So getting back to Joe Burrow, I wanted to ask, so let's, the conversation up until now has been like, will he come back healthy from that knee injury and look like the same guy? Now, because of all the hype and what's being reported in training camp when nobody's hitting and there's no pads and blah, 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 like how good can the Bengals be? If Joe Burrow comes back and is closer to the prospect we thought he would be than the guy we saw as a rookie who was good, but not great, and there were some questions about, you know, a few parts of his game. If he comes back and looks more like what we expected to see from Joe Burrow, how good can the Bengals be next year?
I'm still a little worried about the defensive side of the ball. And we're in that boat, too. We spent the whole offseason just talking about their offensive line and just debating, well, they need a receiver, which they didn't technically need, but they did, right? Mm-hmm. You want to be three deep. We like that. And their offensive line, their defense... still, you know, it's Trey Waynes and Chidobe Awuzie in the secondary. The Awuzie move I liked, and Mike Hilton was a nice addition there. The linebackers haven't been good for years. And they just invested heavily on Sam Hubbard and Trey Hendrickson on the defensive line at edge. They're good players. They're good players. It's a pretty heavy investment for guys that I think are good, not great. So I think the defense has some question marks. Yeah. But I think the Bengals can be really good. Cause I would say Burrow can play like a tier two quarterback, which immediately makes you a potential 8-10 win team.
I'm now, because of what we saw from Josh Allen, I'm now really intrigued by quarterbacks that just sucked passing deep for a year.
Now, listen, this was the argument. This was one of the things I clung to in my Sam Darnold analysis. Sam Darnold at USC was excellent. Short, intermediate, accuracy was good,
but
grading was good. Intermediate stuff was incredible, and it was like his deep ball is just off. He doesn't have great touch, and he misses and this and that. And I was like, well, when you get the right receivers, you have a few more open throws. The same arguments I always made, and that never really happened for Sam Darnold.
It did
happen for Josh Allen.
2 points, though, that I would make. One is there's a difference between college and the NFL, obviously, and two, Burrow has shown it before. Like, we've seen Burrow with a deep ball.
I looked up. I was like, hey, that's me.
Like, we've seen Joe Burrow be extremely accurate on deep passes. It's not like that isn't there. It just has. True. It just wasn't there as a rookie. So last year, in terms of PFF grade on everything except the deep ball, right? Here's a list of quarterbacks. Deshaun Watson, Patrick Mahomes, Aaron Rodgers, Josh Allen, Tom Brady, Joe Burrow. Ahead of Russell Wilson, Kirk Cousins, Tannehill, blah, blah, blah. So really, what, like, Burrow's deep ball was bad. Make no bones about it. It was
horrendous
last year. Really bad, but Allen was the same thing the year before, right? Actually a really good, really well-graded quarterback on everything other than the deep ball. Deep ball was, I think, the worst in the NFL, Josh Allen in 2019.
Our conversation last year at this time.
If he finds a deep ball.
You were like laughing at him too, at how bad some of his throws were.
I mean, comical.
They were landing out of bounds. Like, it was off. It was
ridiculous.
Terrible. Yes.
But we were saying, if he finds a deep ball, there is a big step to be made immediately. Now, we didn't anticipate the step he made, but like, I'm now in, because that happened, because the precedent is there, I'm now really interested by the idea that Joe Burrow in year two with Ja'Marr Chase there now and has the capacity to take a big leap.
And part of deep ball success is a little dependent on the receivers.
Sure. I mean,
the actual like results definitely depend heavily on the receivers, but even just throwing the ball accurately. You have Ja'Marr Chase and T. Higgins now as downfield threats. Let's also not forget, Burrow was thrown to A.J. Green, who had the second low. I mean, he was N'Keal Harry-esque.
Yeah.
At getting open last year.
He was
Harry, the guy that is can't find a place to play because he can't get open. And that's how A.J. Green played, unfortunately.
A.J. Green was hurting Joe Burrow last season. It sounds ridiculous. And before the year, we were saying, hey, keep A.J. Green around because it'll help Burrow.
Yeah.
Like, he was genuinely hindering Joe Burrow last season because he was so bad at getting separation. So every target you sent his way was effectively a bad decision.
We have to get down to training camp and go see this hype. Can we get down? Can we get over there? Bengals, are you listening? Let us into training camp so we can see Joe.
Yeah. But I'm now really fascinated by this idea of, hey, if Burrow takes a big step forward. Because look, Joe Burrow, okay, it was a limited sample size, but Burrow the prospect, Burrow the draft quarterback, was as good as we've ever seen. And that's happened, like, this has been, the bar's been moved, you know, sequentially higher, like the Olympics, where it just keeps getting up, up, up. like Baker was the best we'd ever seen. And then Kyler Murray's season rivaled anything we saw from Baker. And then Joe Burrow was another step higher again. So it has been sort of getting edged up over the last few years. But that year of Burrow at LSU was phenomenal.
It was incredible. He did not have one bad game. Did it all in the SEC. Even though defense is getting worse in the SEC, right. It's still not at that Big 12 level.
That question mark.
Right. He was just phenomenal. And Burrow did not have a great offensive line
right.
at LSU. You know, like Baker had pristine offensive line, great play caller, great playmakers, everything. Burrow definitely had great playmakers and Joe Brady as a play caller, but he was still running for his life a little bit at LSU as well.